So today we are going to discuss about how all the layers works together. Suppose your computer contact with Google. G stands for Google. Let my IP address is IA and Google IP address is let IG. Now in this case suppose I can say that if my computer A and Google is present in the same network, then in this case you need not to go to router. You can directly contact Google and Google will send you whatever you require. Clear? That is if your computer and Google present in the your computer and Google present in the same network. But this is case one. Case two is if there is your computer A and in between Google server and your computer, here you are supposed to send the message. Case two, like this, you can say this A is here and this router is connected to Google. This is network 2 and this is network 1. Here you are supposed to send the message to the router, and the router supposed to send it to the Google. Clear? Then Google will reply it. Whenever your computer and Google are present in two different network. Clear? So question arises here is how will source A will know that Google is present in same or different network? By using subnet mask. What will happen? Now the IP address of my computer is IA. We have to perform AND operation with subnet mask of A, that is subnet mask of my computer, so that I will get network ID of my computer A according to subnet mask of A. Again, if Google IP address is IG and subnet mask of my computer is SA, then if we perform AND operation, if I get a network ID of Google server according to A means this A, subnet mask of A, if these two are equals, then Google server and my computer present in same network. If it is not equal, then Google server and my computer are present in two different network. We have to perform the IP address of how question is how will source A will source A source source A will come to know that whether Google is present in same network or different network. That can be done using subnet mask. If what is my IP address, that is what is the my computer IP address is IA, I have to, and subnet mask is SA. Clear? Then I have to perform AND operation. My IP address AND operation with subnet mask of A. Then I will get the network address of A according to A. Again, to check whether Google is present in same network or different network, what will happen? Now Google IP address is IG. We have to perform subnet mask of A. Clear? Perform AND operation. We have to perform AND operation. Then I will get network ID of Google according to A. If these two are equal, then Google and my computer are present in same network. If these two are not equal network ID, then both are present in two different network. Clear? Let host A wants to send a message to Google. Clear? Assume that Google is not in the same network. A knows that Google is not present in the same network. How? Because it has already performed the perform AND operation with the subnet mask of A. Hence, A knows Google is not present in the same network. Google is present on different network. Now, assume that A is present in one network, and every network is going to have a default router. Every network is going to have a default router. Clear? And this is the R1 router. R1 is the default gateway of A. Clear? So message starts from application layer. Clear? Message starts from application layer. This is message. Clear? Now message starts from application layer. Clear? So message transport to transport layer. Then transport layer add many things to the header of this message. That is, transport layer add header to this message, but in the header there are many important things, but the important thing is port number, because transport layer is responsible for end-to-end connectivity. Let source port number is X. Source port number X means S port number is X. Clear? And Google port number is 80. So transport layer is responsible for adding the port number. AS port number is X, that is source port number is X, and destination port number, that is Google's port number, is 80. Now message given to the network layer. Clear? This message, that means the total message transport to network layer. This will be X80. Now this total message transport to network layer. So network layer takes MX80 and add a header. The important is IP address, because the network layer is responsible for host to host connectivity. Network layer is responsible for host to host connectivity, but transport layer is responsible for end to end connectivity. So every host is uniquely identified by IP address. Let assume IP address of A is IA. Then network layer is responsible for adding IP address. So IP address of source is IA, and IP address of Google is let IZ. Clear? Now this message is transferred to data link layer. This message is transferred to data link layer. This is message X80IAIG. But data layer layer adds header and trailer. In the header, the most important thing is MAC address because of hop to hop connectivity. So communication within the single network and the number which are going to be useful in single network are physical address. Let assume router IP address is router IP address, this is R1, IP address is IR1, clear, and its MAC address is MR1, its MAC address is MR1. Its router IP address is IR1 and MAC address is MR1. So to fill the this destination, here the source MAC address will be MA. Now to fill this destination MAC address, what will happen? To fill this destination physical address, we found that Google is not in the same network because Google is present in different network. Clear? Hence, packets sent to the router, and hence destination MAC address should be router MAC address. In IP configure of a computer, you can see that IP configure of computer, you will find out your IP address, MAC address, along with this ISP going to give you the DNS IP address to get the IP address of destination along with default gateway. Clear? Here the default router is R1. Clear? And its default IP address is and the router IP address is IR1. So default gateway address already provided by ISP, which is already in your computer. Hence, as a host A, know the IP address of R1. But then you want to know MAC of R1. ARP means, you want to know the MAC of R1 because we cannot send a frame without MAC address. So host A send a ARP request. Host A send a ARP request to this router R1. Clear? Because we cannot send a frame without so host A send ARP request to R1. This ARP request will be seen by there can be many hosts can be connected to this network. These are host S2, S3, S4, S5. These are host. Clear? So this ARP request will be seen by every host present in this network. That is A asking, I know the IP address of R1, but I do not know the MAC of R1. Please send me the MAC of R1. Then R1 send the MAC address of R1 and put MR1 in the frame destination address. Now physical layer takes the MR1, takes DLL data. Now it will this. Whenever A sends the ARP request, then R1 will reply, it will give a reply that my MAC address is MR1. Then source A will fill MAC address as MR1. Now this message sent to the physical layer. Clear?